For the second time in 5 months, a U.S. diplomatic post has been the target of a deadly assault. A suicide bomber detonated a vest with explosives outside the U.S. embassy in Ankara, Turkey today, killing himself and a security guard. The White House described it as a terrorist attack.
The explosion occurred around 1:15 p.m. local time. Afterward, police tried to hold back the crowd gathered outside the U.S. facility in the Turkish capital. Debris littered the street near a side entrance where the blast took place. Emergency workers wheeled one of the injured into an awaiting ambulance. U.S. Ambassador to Turkey Francis Ricciardoni spoke to reporters outside the embassy.
Right now, we are all dealing with our sadness at the loss of our fellow member of our embassy. We salute his bravery, his service to Turkey and to Turkish-American friendship. Our hearts go out to his family.
In Istanbul, Prime Minister Recep Tayyip Erdogan called the bombing an attack against peace in our country. And in Washington, the State Department's Victoria Nuland said a series of security upgrades to the Ankara embassy saved lives.
Where this happened was on an external perimeter access site far from the main building. It is that kind of setback, that kind of hardening, that kind of structure that we've been working on over the past 10 years that actually ensured that this wasn't far worse than it could have been.
No group has claimed responsibility for the bombing, but Turkish officials said it was the work of an outlawed domestic militant front.
A short time ago, I spoke to Tülin Daloglu in Ankara. She's a reporter for Al Monitor, a media website that covers developments in the Middle East. Welcome to you. Well, you arrived on the scene shortly after the explosion. Tell us what you saw.
I talked to the witnesses, the neighbors here, and people told me that there was a huge explosion. The sound was really too loud, and they, you know, said that the walls trembled in their homes, and they felt that their organs had shaken. And so they immediately understood that something went terribly wrong at the U.S. embassy, at their neighbor. And as I looked around, I seen that, you know, also our journalists, the Turkish correspondents here, were kind of calm and quiet, because the only injured who's now at the hospital is one of ours, a Turkish correspondent, diplomatic correspondent.
Now, the Turkish Interior Minister said the bomber was a member of a far-left group. What is known about this group and why they might attack a U.S. facility?
Well, this group, named Revolutionary People's Liberation Party, in Turkish we call it with an abbreviation DHKPC, was founded in 1978. And it's a secular terrorist organization, different from the Islamist-leaning terrorist organizations. It embraces a Marxist-Leninist ideology. It is anti-imperialist, anti-U.S., and anti-NATO, for that matter. It had attacked U.S. interests and facilities during and, you know, before and after the first Gulf War. But they hadn't done anything for a long time. So today is the first after, you know, a long break that they had attacked the U.S. embassy here in Ankara.
Now, do we know how clear the evidence is that points to them? And I ask this because I've seen some terrorism experts here in the U.S. Questioning about whether the Turkish government has rushed to judgment, I guess, a bit in pinpointing this group, particularly because there are any number of groups operating in Turkey capable of such violence.
True, there are a number of terrorist organizations, from, you know, extremist leftists to Kurdish to Islamist terrorist organizations operating in Turkey. I wouldn't go into speculating further than what the Turkish authorities have provided to the Turkish media, and we're hoping that, the coming days we are going to have more details as to why this happened and why DHKPC or whoever targeted the U.S. embassy today had done so. We don't know really much detail tonight.
Tülin Daloglu is in Ankara for us tonight. Thanks so much.
Thank you so much.